In this video, we want to discuss about coroutine. What is coroutine and what are the advantages do we have when we use Kotlin coroutine? We will discuss in this video. Let's get started. So first, I'm going to create here main function and I will try to elaborate you all the things with practical example. So we have two more function. We have first function and we have second function. And in this main, I'm going to simply call it first and second. So when you create any process or launching an application in your Android operating system, under the hood, it will create something what we call main routine. It is a core part of every program because it's where you set up and run all of your other components in your code. Because our main function is an entry point to our program, this will eventually become a part of our main routine. So I'm gonna just mention it in here. So this is a part of our main routine, and in this main function we do have two function. Basically we are calling two function, so it will also use a new routine. So for the first we have a different routine, for the second we have a different routine. This is our function, main function, that contains two function call, first and second. So our Android operating system will create a programming call stack, and in that call stack it will simply insert all of the function calls that we will make during our program, or you can say function execution. So just like this, we have a stack, and in this stack, first we will insert the main function, because main function is the part of our main routine. So it will insert main in our call stack, or you can say programming call stack. Next, it will insert the first function call, and once the execution of first function call is done, it will simply remove it, or you can say pop this thing from our programming call stack. After that, we will insert the second function call in our programming call stack, and once the execution of second function is done, then it will simply remove it from the programming call stack, as you can see in here. And lastly, when it removes the main function, that means our stack is empty. That means the program execution is successfully completed. So this is how a routine will work. Once the execution of first function is done, then only it will trigger the second function. This is what we call blocking invocation. Let me just show you. So I'm using here println and use here first, then use here println and we use second. Now when you execute it, you will see the first and second. Subroutine is used to invoke a blocking call, but with Kotlin coroutine, it is not the case. You can use non-blocking execution using coroutine. Now let's see how we can do this thing. So for that, I'm going to show you another example so that for you, it's very easy to understand. So let's say I'm using here a infinite loop, and in this infinite loop, I'm going to use this println function and paste in here. And on top of our while, I'm going to create a variable first, and initial value is 10. And I will increment it one by one. So first plus plus. Just copy this thing, paste in your second function, cut this thing from here, and change this thing from first to second. And similarly, change this thing from first to second. And it will start from zero. So we have two functions, right? First function and second function. And now when I execute it, you will never see this second print statement. This is because, as I told you, in our stack, first we have main, then we have first. So when the execution of first is completed, then only we will execute the second function. So this is the problem, and that is why you are not able to see here the second print statement, because it will never reach up to this place. So this is a problem with subroutine. Well, with coroutine, you can simply make this blocking invocation into a non-blocking invocation. So let's see how we can do this. So for the time being, when you open the console, you will never see the second print statement. First, let me just stop the process. And now I'm gonna use here coroutine. So first, let me just change the type of our main function from nothing to unit, and I'm using here run blocking. We will discuss about run blocking, launch, and everything that you will see in here, but for time being, just be with me. Now instead of launching a subroutine, I'm gonna use here coroutine. So this is my first coroutine and this is my second coroutine. In our first launch, I'm using first. In our second coroutine, I'm using here second. And I'm gonna use here suspend keyword in front of my functions. And also I want to produce some delay for 2 seconds in our second, for 1 second in our first function. And now this time when you execute this function, you will see first, second, then second, first, second. Means it is executing parallelly. Your first function, your second function is executing parallelly. This is possible only because your coroutine is a non-blocking invocation. It will execute your first function and second function in a non-blocking way. That is why your thread is free. Due to that reason, you can execute these two functions parallelly. This is a plus point of having Kotlin coroutine. The main difference between subroutine and coroutine is subroutine is used to invoke a blocking call, while coroutine is used to execute or invoke a non-blocking call. This is a difference. I think you got the advantage of using Kotlin coroutine instead of a subroutine. Well, just comment this thing out. I forgot to comment. Simply comment it and re-execute it. You will see 10, 0, 1, 1, 12, 13. So basically it is executing parallelly, and this is a plus point of having Kotlin coroutine. So that's it for this video. I hope you got the concept of coroutine. What are the difference between subroutine and coroutine? What is routine? I think you got everything. That's all for this video. In our next video, we'll discuss launch and run blocking. Till that, goodbye.